Thank you very much, Sylvie. Bonjour, tout le monde. I'm very sorry, but I can't speak in French. I can understand you a bit, but I can't speak in French, so I'm going to present in English. First, I would like to thanks Elliott Spear Organizing Committee for the kind invitation to be here to present you this European Network for Assuring Food Integrity Using Non-Destructive Spectral Sensors. This is an European project. This is a cross action. And the short name of the action is Sensor Fin. So I'm very happy to can introduce all of you this project. Let me introduce you what is a cross action that is not a research project. It is instead of this is an open and inclusive networks of excellence. It's possible to propose cross action in all the scientific domains, and in this case, we have proposed this sensor fins cross action in the topic of non-destructive spectral sensor applied to food integrity assessment. The idea of this kind of project is to connect all the stakeholders that are involved in this area. I mean, with this, that is not just dedicated to academia. In this project, can be involved the industry, the public and private sectors. And the idea is to share the demand in this area and to come look for solution together. And of course, the important thing is to do a strong network to work together in future projects. I have seen that the previous presentation regarding the Horizon Europe, I think all of us are now involved in looking for a new consortium to do this. This is also the idea of this kind of action to enlarge the network of people working in the same area of you, and in the future can collaborate in more and more different projects and different ways of doing science. To introduce you, here you can see the activities that are funded by a cross action. As can you see, the cross action are funding meetings, workshops, conferences, training school in specific topics, short-term scientific mission. In this case, this is one of the action that we encourage more in this kind of project because it's a lot of, in particular, early investigators, but also seniors, to move between different institutions, labs, and this is a very good option to do mobilities that can be short mobilities, I mean with this 1 week, or mobilities of 2 or 3 months. And also, of course, dissemination activities of the action. Talking now about the sensor field context of our action, if you think about which is the current situation in the food sector, if you think about the consumer or if you think about the food industry, the demands are what you can see in this slide. The consumers are now demanding a food supply system that produces safe food, nutritious food, but also authentic food. That now is a very, very important requirement. And also, if we look at the industry, the needs of control in the products and in the process are every day higher. I mean with this that they need to detection, of course, the fraud, they need to authenticate the production, they need to fulfill the specific regulation in the area they work on. they have to manage with the implementation of good manufacturing practice and guaranteeing levels, because the consumer are demanding this and this every day more. And also they have to self-control the production. In this case, the control of the production is a very important point, because with this, they are going to be more efficient, and this means to save money. And this is very important in this case, because at the end, an industry is a business. Our action, our sensor fin action match very well with the currently trends and innovation in product control. I mean with this that today, you know that the Green Deal of the European Union is demanding the fund to fork a control, no? In this case, what they are demanding is that we have to assure the food integrity of the production along the whole food chain. I mean with this that we have to control in the primary sector, in the farm, but also in the industry, but also in the transport, in all related to the distribution and logistics, until arrive to the consumer. And for this, the traditional methods are not enough. So we need to innovate in this. And of course, the spectral sensors are an opportunity for this, because they are very fast, precise, easy to use. They are very versatile. We can use for several products and several parameters. Are not contaminant. That is very, very important today also. And non-destructive. This allow us to control all the production. So this is very important, because we are changing the idea of the control of the products. We are changing. We can control all the production, not just specific batches. So this is an integral control. And also it's a digital signal. And this is very important. You know that now we are in the digitalization period. Everything have to be digital. And in this case, the control of product and process have to be also digital. And in this case, this sensor could provide us this answer that is demanding by the industry and also by the consumer, as I introduced before. So in this context, the main objective of this cost action is the creation of a lively and multidisciplinary network to generate and disseminate knowledge about non-destructive effectual sensors and their application for the real-time in-situ control of critical quality, safety, authenticity, and performance attributes of raw and in-process food materials, involving the entire food chain, as I explained before. This action, sensor fins, will enable also to reduce the gap between the academia and the industry, boosting the implementation of this sensor in the food industry and improving the European food industry competitiveness. The execution period of this action is 4 years. The action starts at the end of the 2020. It's going to be running until the end of the year 2024. So really, we are at the beginning of the action, and I have to say that this year it has been very, very difficult by the situation with the pandemic. About the action plan that we have in this sensor fin project is this. We have five work groups in this action. The first one is dedicated to the use of a spectral sensor for the innovation in the process control and labeling in the European food industry. The second one is related to the integration of several sensors for answer to critical issues in food integrity. I mean, with it, that sometimes it's not enough to use just NIR, to use just Raman, and maybe the combination of imaging and NIR, of fluorescence and NIR and imaging could be very useful for specific complex issues. The third work group is dedicated to mathematical algorithms and methodologies for processing the data in real time. This is the most important thing now, because we want to enable that the industry has the sensors online in situ, and